Let us begin. From where do we start?
Raja Ravi Verma.
Raja Ravi Verma. Okay. So you want me to share the screen, because frankly speaking, I don't have a lot of knowledge about Raja Ravi Verma paintings, but I have some perception about it, why he stood out in the crowd of those days or in history. So okay. should we open a couple of images of Raja Ravi Verma?
Yeah. By all means. Raja Ravi Verma, you know, comes from a very aristocratic family. His mother's side is that of kingdom of Travancore. That time it was Travancore, not Kerala. So. And there was a matriarchal line of succession at that point of time. Mm. So he was born in royalty. He was very close to royalty. He's a very privileged painter. At the same time, he also came in contact with a Dutch painter who taught him. I think at Madurai. Painting, and a British person who worked as his dealer or of sorts. So it is basically a fusion of European academic style of painting and Indian subjects. Now, imagine a world without, where there is no camera. There are no cameras, and the only paintings you have seen are two dimensional or not very realistically done three dimensional paintings. And then you see Raja Ravi Verma's work. That is the impact of his work at that point of time when he was painting.
But is it not? What I find Raja Ravi Verma's work. I mean, this is an interesting thing, that art must be seen in the context it was done. If the timeline is messed up, then a piece of art which is highly appreciated. It becomes very cliche, because if we look at his paintings, these are extreme order of realistic paintings where the objects, the human bodies, human figures, etc., like as good as, let's say, Michelangelo, things like that. Not Michelangelo, Leonardo da Vinci. That kind of realism is there. That extreme realism, extreme order of realism, reflects on the human figures or clothes, the folds of the clothes, etc. But then when Raja Ravi Verma painted it, long before, how long? Maybe it's 1500. So close to 300 years before, this was...
No, 19th century. 19th century.
That's what. Leonardo is when? Leonardo is 15th century, right?
15th, okay.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So, 300 years before, this was a cliche already in Europe, in Western art. Now, but it stands out in Acha. And now, if we look at today, these paintings, this kind of stuff every Tom, Dick and Harry is doing, who has mastered a little bit of skill, good skill, I would say. There is no dearth of skill in today's Indian context. Everyone can draw a mango like a mango. Now, this again is a cliche in today's context. But in my opinion, Raja Ravi Verma stands out for two reasons. At that point of time, when he painted, the Indian scene of art was going through a radical transformation, because this kind of realism was not the tradition in Indian context for almost 1000 years or so. Indian art was largely, the paintings were largely miniature style, where there was hardly any likeness between the painted image and the person, and it was different. There was no perspective, was not, did not play the did not play a very important role in Indian painting until the Britishers, until the Western influence came very rapid, very, very strongly. So in this situation, what was happening, the paintings which were being done, being pursued, was a kind of a mix of Western influence and the Aboriginal Indian way. That is what was being pursued. But suddenly comes someone in the middle of this, who is Ravi Verma, who brings in the acute likeness, the extreme order of realism, which is celebrated, which was being celebrated in the West 300 years before, and just nowhere in India. And he employed that kind of skill. It's like a quantum jump. You take some time for anything to start from one level and reach another level. But Ravi Verma seems to be somebody who, in Indian context, when this was not existing at all, he achieved the level of skill of Leonardo da Vinci in a single lifetime, in a single shot, with absolutely no backdrop of it, no history of it in India. And the Western style, as you said, is employed to depict Indian mythology. So these two unique things, I think, made him stand out in the crowd. And here, I mean, I'm just spelling out my view. This is very important for artists of any generation to realize that doing the same stuff which is in vogue, which is in vogue, actually doesn't make one stand out. Acute deviation from the standard makes the artwork, stand out in the crowd. And this is exactly what Ravi Verma did. And the uniqueness is because he did at a time when it was absurd. Today, somebody doing it makes no sense. I mean, this is done so many times. What are we doing? New. Reinventing the wheel. That's what my view. Yeah. Sushant Raval, can you say something? What you feel about? You are muted. All of us putting in some of our views would make it very interesting. Sushant is not speaking, he is only listening. Manani, I know you are busy. I'm not insisting you to speak, but if you feel like putting in a word or two, that would be great. Anyhow, this is Ravi Verma. It's realism. And as I always keep harping, that doing the same thing as everyone else is doing makes no sense. Partho, you see this, you can see this image. I mean, you have seen Ravi Verma's painting. No? These are one of those legendary, yes. He's one of the legendary artists in Indian history.
Mm-hmm, right.
So that's what I say, because this kind of painting, in my opinion, aaj ki situation mein dekha jaye to ek bhi naya cheez nahi hai. Facebook khologe to so many realistic artists, realistic paintings are seen. women
bathing
and stuff. Yeah.
This is still different. The realism we see today is very much like a photograph. It's photorealism.
This was nearly so.
I think, because of the lack of availability of color, the kind of shades we easily have access to today.
Yeah, it was not.
The paintings look like paintings, You know what I mean? The paintings do not look like a photograph. The paintings look like paintings.
Rohan, here I slightly disagree with you. I am unable to find. I have seen Raja Ravi Verma's paintings right before me in Hyderabad, I think Salarjung Gallery Museum. There is a small painting section, very small, and there are some 3-4 Ravi Verma paintings. Also in in Baroda, the palace, which palace, Sayaji Palace or something, they have a good collection of Ravivarma paintings. They are like photorealistic. Eh? They are like photorealistic. I mean, I'll tell you.
No, I have also been to Salarjung. 2015 or 16.
Salarjung.
It's in Hyderabad, no?
Hyderabad.
So, no, see, the... I'm talking about the color, you know, the color in particular. The skin doesn't look like the skin. Exactly. The skin looks like a glamorized version of the skin. Now, to pick any close-up photograph.
Yes.
The skin looks like a very glowing kind of a...
Maybe, as you said, that he had a lack of availability of this much of variety of paint. But of course, when Raja Ravi Varma painted, paints were available in tubes and bottles. It's not the time. And not only that, definitely there was camera already in existence. So both were in availability. Of course, I mean, today, like for instance, I was just checking the paintings by Banani's guru. Let me open. Pretty similar, actually. Sudhir Mehra. You will see bit similar paintings. See this realism. I take this one. This is a contemporary celebrated artist. Sudhir. I'm just opening. Now
sorry, there was a problem with my.
Can you people see? Yeah. Now, yes, it looks little more realistic than Ravi Varma, but it's in the same line. It's in the same line. In the same direction.
I mean, if you observe color, then maybe you will agree with my point. You know, because he uses heavy yellow in his painting. I feel, you know.
Who you mean, Ravi Varma?
Ravi Varma, yes.
Yeah.
And it's a very yes. See.
Yes, lot of yellow. Yes.
So maybe they were candlelit subjects.
Yeah. And is it so? Is it true? I don't know that he kept painting his wife in every woman he painted. I heard somewhere. I don't know. The other day, Mr. Moria was telling me that way.
No. He's painted a lot of women. You know, he painted women who he thought were beautiful as mythological figures.
Yeah, but the faces are pretty much similar. Right? Faces, if you see, faces don't differ radically. Anyhow, okay. So that is Ravi Varma. I mean, somehow. If you ask me, I don't find a very shocking, I mean, he is not my favorite because what happened is it's like you love a song of Rahul Dev Barman and then you don't hear it much, but you keep hearing the remix. So that is what has happened to me. I mean, in today's situation, I see so many realistic paintings of women in particular. This impression became a cliche and then it gets overlapped on Ravi Varma's painting. But when Ravi Varma did, it was a different world. It was new.
Exactly. Absolutely. See, retrospectively, looking back at what precedes us.
Today's light is not right.
Yeah. Today we are more in, you know, we can look. I was talking to a friend a couple of days ago. He said anybody who came before us, even if had a little bit of intelligence, became famous.
Yeah. Yeah. No,
I disagree with that. I don't agree with that. But that it happens. You know, we have a tendency to look back and sort of not be impressed. But I personally find it impressive, his work, the quality of it, and nobody painting like him at that point of time in the Indian context, is something important to note, and because it is one of the foundations.
Yeah, Joel has joined. Joel is a deadly artist. I mean, Rohan, you have not seen Joel's paintings, probably. I don't know if you have seen. He will love. I mean, not at all conventional. It's not very different.
Not deadly exactly. I'm just a beginner. I just started say 10 years back. I was in illustrations and designing all, and I have some books authored by me also. But painting was my first passion. But due to my circumstances, I was unable to devote myself onto the painting. So that was the bad part. But still, I'm doing. And I appreciate that you're appreciating my work.
Yeah, I like your work.
Thank you. But I don't see myself as a very established work. I'm still in this struggling period. Maybe after 10 years or so, I may get something good from me.
आपने जो बताया, मैं थोड़ा बनानी ने वो म्यूट ही रखेगी आज, कोई पॉसिबिलिटी नहीं है, बट शी इज लिसनिंग, आई एम श्योर. Here there is something interesting for Banani, because Banani started 6 years ago, and so it's something interesting for her to note that Joel is saying that मैंने अभी चालू किया. तो कब चालू किया? 10 साल पहले.
हाँ, exactly. मुझे इनफैक्ट मुझे लगता है कि पेंटिंग तो मैं कर रहा था 18-19 पे. मेरे को एक वो भी मिली थी कॉलेज में जब था, लोग जानने लगे थे. लेकिन वो सर्कमस्टांसेस ऐसे हुए कि मैं फिर शिफ्ट कर गया जॉब पे, कमर्शियल में. एंड यू सी मनी प्रायोरिटी होती है कई बार आपके सर्कमस्टांसेस के हिसाब से. तो वो मुश्किल हुई मुझे टोटली ऑन टू पेंटिंग. फिर मैं, क्योंकि मैं बाल भवन में था तो पेंटिंग से जुड़ा ही रहा. बाल भवन इज रिक्रिएशनल सेंटर फॉर चिल्ड्रन. सो किसी ना किसी तरीके से मेरा चलता रहा. बट टोटली पेंटिंग में जब मैं आने के लिए, जब मेरे को लगा कि अब मेरा टाइम बीतता जा रहा है, एट 43 आई टुक वॉलंटरी रिटायरमेंट फ्रॉम दी बल्बो. इट्स अ गवर्नमेंट जॉब. तो 43 की एज पे मैंने बिल्कुल छोड़ दिया. एंड लोगों ने कहा क्या ये बेवकूफी कर रहा है, इतना बड़ा सेक्शन संभालता है, ये वो जो भी चलता है. लेकिन मुझे लगा कि मैंने अब नहीं छोड़ा तो कभी नहीं छोड़ पाऊंगा. उसके बाद भी मुझे आई लेफ्ट बल्बो इन 2003. And 2007, I started painting. मतलब 4 साल मुझे कमर्शियल भी छोड़ने में टाइम लगा. NCERT वगैरह, SCERT वगैरह की बुक्स में illustrations है मेरी. लेकिन मुझे पेंटिंग, मुझे लगता है कि बिल्कुल एकदम डिफरेंट लाइन है. पेंटिंग के लिए आपको एक अलग लाइफ जीनी होती है. पेंटिंग के लिए अलग से सबकॉन्शियस माइंड में काम करना पड़ता है. मैं आप लोग राजा रवि वर्मा के लिए बात कर रहे थे, इनफैक्ट उनके थीसिस के लिए बात कर रहे थे. होता क्या है कि आर्टिस्ट का एक परसेप्शन होती है एक ब्यूटी की. तो वो सिमिलर फेसेस हैं, नहीं है, वो बेसिकली जिस चीज को सुंदर मानता है, या हो सकता है उसके सामने कुछ मॉडल्स भी रहे हों उस वक्त. मुझे नहीं पता कितना मॉडलिंग का टाइम था राजा रवि वर्मा के टाइम में. लेकिन ऑब्वियसली जो, जैसे अभी एक बोल रहे थे कि उनकी वाइफ शायद उनसे जुड़ी हुई थी, या उनकी वाइफ, तो वो ओरिजिनली क्या होता है कि जो आपके आसपास वुमेन होती है या जो भी फॉर्म होती है, आप उसी से चीजों को लेके चलते हैं. तो वो ऑब्वियसली उसका आइडियल फिगर रही होगी, तो उसने अपनी वाइफ को भी पेंट किया हो, तो इसमें कोई बुरी बात नहीं है.
ऑफ कोर्स ना, मेरा एक ही कहना है. आई मीन frankly, like Rohan is very big fan of Ravi Verma. I am not much of fan. My problem is this. I mean, एक art, piece of art को time की context में, unless it is seen in that context of the time, sometimes the art loses its meaning. Actually, that is what my problem is, because आज की situation में इतने सारे लोग रियलिस्टिक पेंटिंग कर रहे हैं और वीमेन की पेंटिंग कर रहे हैं प्रेटी मच इन अ सिमिलर पैटर्न एक्चुअली एंड इन फैक्ट टुडे द व्हाट आई शुड फोटो रियलिज्म एज रोहन सेज इज इवन स्ट्रॉन्गर इवन ऑफ हायर ऑर्डर दैट इट इज लाइक फॉर मी व्हाट हैज हैपेंड आई हैव बीन बॉम्बार्डेड विथ रिमिक्स एंड व्हेन आई लुक बैक द ओरिजिनल आई फाइंड ओ इट्स अ क्लिशे मैं काफी सारे रिमिक्स देख रहा हूँ आज की सिचुएशन में मैंने ये था नहीं
ये एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन का टाइम एक्चुअली अभी क्या हो रहा है कि आप सोचो कब से पेंटिंग चल रही है वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड से आप लगाओ तो कितनी शताब्दियां बीत गई हैं और अभी आप कुछ भी करोगे वो पता लगेगा इंटरनेट पे जाओगे कि समथिंग हैज ऑलरेडी हैपेंड समवेयर इन द पार्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड तो वो नयापन नहीं दिखता फिर आपको फिर आप एक्सपेरिमेंट करने की पोजिशन पे आते हो एक और बात एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन एक जगह और हो रहा है वो ये है कि फास्ट फूड का टाइम हो रहा है लोगों को ये लग रहा है कि कुछ ऐसा शॉर्टकट सा अपनाया जाए जिससे हम पेंटिंग को जल्दी से पेंटिंग पेंटर बन जाऊं या एक नाम हो जाए सॉरी अगर किसी को इससे ना इत्तेफाकी है तो लेकिन मेरे को लगता है कि लोग शॉर्टकट्स में ज्यादा विश्वास करते हैं वो पेंटिंग जो है वो एक ऑटोमेटिक सिस्टम है जो आपके अंदर आता है वो एक टाइम के साथ में आता है आप करते रहो और राजा रवि वर्मा की मैंने मॉडर्न आर्ट गैलरी में गैलरी पूरी है उसको डिवोटेड है मैंने वो देखी है और उसमें आप देखोगे राजा रवि वर्मा ने बहुत काम किया उन्होंने स्टाइलाइजेशन भी किया हुआ है उन्होंने फोक को भी आगे शायद एक्सटेंड किया हुआ है मैंने राजा रवि वर्मा को इतना स्टडी नहीं किया हुआ है कि बहुत रियलिस्टिक करते थे लेकिन जितना मैं जानता हूँ उस टाइम में उस वक्त में आज के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में उनको देखना मेरे ख्याल ठीक नहीं होगा उनको उसी कॉन्टेक्स्ट में देखना पड़ेगा जिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट में वो रहते थे
दैट्स एग्जैक्टली
फुल्ली बहुत जरूरी है
दैट्स एग्जैक्टली एब्सोल्युटली दिस इज व्हाट आई वाज सेइंग दैट ही इज काइंड ऑफ अ ऑड वन आउट ड्यूरिंग दैट पीरियड तभी जो आई मीन रियलिस्टिक पेंटिंग का कोई जमाना नहीं था इन इंडियन कॉन्टेक्स्ट एट ऑल एंड दे वर वर्किंग टुवर्ड्स समथिंग अ मिक्स ऑफ वेस्टर्न वेज एंड इंडियन वेज उस टाइम पे सडनली समबडी अचीव रीचेस अ गैप ऑफ प्रोबेबली 300-400 इयर्स इन अ सिंगल लाइफ टाइम एंड पेंट्स लाइक दिस विदाउट एनी प्रायर एक्सपीरियंस मैंने एक्सपीरियंस तो हमारा एक जनरेशन का शायद नहीं होते हैं वी आर बोर्न विद एक्सपीरियंसेस फॉर पास्ट एनी हाउ सो ओके सो रोहन शुड वी गो फॉर अनदर वन
प्लीज डू डू
आल्सो समथिंग वी हैव हार्डली टच्ड अपॉन इज यू नो हिज depiction of mythology which is a different subject altogether you yes. know to for the purpose of appreciation now to appreciate his depiction of mythology one has to look at how other people depicted mythologies at that point of time you know so that is something we have left out and you know perhaps will be in a better position to cover it some other time yeah
okay ठीक
yeah
so should we shift to whom
Bacon and Freud
now, this is my favorite okay so how do we should we open something or Okay, let me go back somewhere. Just a second. Okay, before we get into anything, I mean, we all know, I understand, but still I cannot stop the screen. Stop sharing. So before I we discuss on this, we all may be knowing, but the thing is interesting part. There is a like Ravi Verma actually. There is something very interesting about his work. Just one second. Allow me a second. Hello. Yes. मुझे थोड़ी देर बाद फोन कीजिए मेरा बुकिंग चल रहा है आधा घंटे हाँ जी सो या it's they have one synergy with one aspect. Francis Bacon and Lucian Freud, they are similar with Ravi Verma. Okay, Rohan, tell me how. What do you
I
feel?
I can't tell you
I
how.
I find a similarity between them.
No, I don't. I personally don't.
Yeah, I won't. I've been
enlighten us.
I'm very happy that I have bitten you. So, thing is, you see, the context is important. What is the timeline when Francis Bacon and Lucian Freud, they are contemporaries? Freud was probably little younger than Bacon, I guess, little bit. Now, these two were artists in the West at a time when the practice was not painting portrait or figurative drawing, figurative paintings. These were completely out of fashion at the time. Particularly Freud did portraits. Most of his 80% is portrait. Now, portrait was completely out of fashion, and it was not treated as a superior form of art anymore. Probably 100 years ago. And same was the story was of Bacon. At that time, you have Picasso, you have surrealism, which is dream and all that. A heavy level of abstraction, actually. But these two artists stand out in the middle of all this, in the middle of surrealism, in the middle of heavy, in the middle of cubism, celebration of cubism and all that. They stand out doing something already phased out, already cliche, already old. And that is portraiture.
I think they are more recent than that. I think their time... At the time that they were painting, there was abstract expressionism already.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Of course, recent meaning 1934, 1940, 1950. This guy died at 1995, this Freud. So they cover a long span, but then portraiture was not in vogue anymore. That is the point. Yeah. Nobody was treating portrait as a great work, or nobody was treating figurative drawing as a painting as a great work. But both of them did that. This guy did not do figurative. So this is where another thing. But they did it. They did all that in some different way. That's how they stand out, I guess. So that's why I said that there is one similarity with Ravi Verma in this aspect, that Ravi Verma did something painted in a style which was already cliche in another part of the world, but in this part of the world, it was radical and new, sudden. So an old practice is brought in to wake it up. And similarly, these two artists also stood against the current and painted something which was not being painted anymore those days. This is where the similarity begins and ends.
Okay.
Should I open, let us say, any of his paintings? Which one's open? Abhi batao, iska kuch matlab nikalta hai kya? Mere ko nahi samajh aaya. Violent
bhi lagta hai. Screen share karun na.
I did not
screen
do.
Screen share. No.
Oh. Sorry. Start hi nahi kiya. Ye dekho. Ye aadmi idhar baitha hai. You see the face with the teeth. Then there is an umbrella. Then there is a carcass, actually. Some animal which is cut open violently.
That's a cow, I think.
A cow. Yeah. Achha, yahan pe ek railing jo hai, peculiarly ye railing Bacon, Lucian, Francis Bacon ki kafi painting mein ye railing aata hai bar bar. Podium jaise ban jata hai ye. I don't know why.
it acts as a device to add perspective and three-dimensionality.
Could be. You are right.
Yeah. Now Bacon, something about Bacon. His paintings try to reflect brutality. You know, and in this painting, I mean personally, to talk something other than the context, I would talk about its aesthetics. You know, I think
please.
Aesthetics meaning the composition and the balance. Now how Francis Bacon began his paintings is that he used to see things in series. Most of his paintings are in series, like diptychs and triptychs. You know, two paintings, a set of two paintings or a set of three paintings. This one in particular, he, most of his paintings started without any planning. He did not know until the end what he is going to be painting. So the umbrella, he was definitely trying to make a figure in this one, but the umbrella was not planned, and it just came out as he was painting.
Is it something you are guessing or you know?
No. I know this. I was watching a documentary on Bacon.
Is it so? Yeah. Achha, then explain. Yeah. Please explain this. I want to understand this.
No. I saw it a couple of years ago.
Okay.
I don't remember much of it. But this painting is not planned as such. So he was painting the carcass, I think. But the umbrella and the figure emerged out of the accidents that he made during the painting. So, a good artist knows what accidents to keep and what accidents not to keep. So, he kept these accidents. Also, he developed this habit of painting at the unprimed side of the canvas, the back side of the canvas.
Achha, is it?
Yeah, this is because he ran out of money.
एक कैनवास पे दो पेंटिंग कर देगा ऐसा
सो ही रन आउट ऑफ
इधर भी पेंटिंग करेगा उधर भी करेगा ऐसा बोल रहे हैं
हाँ बिकॉज फ्रॉइड एंड दिस गाय वर गैम्बलिंग बडीज एंड दे वर बोथ कंपल्सिव गैम्बलर्स सो एनीथिंग दे मेड आउट ऑफ आर्ट दे यूज टू स्पेंड इन गैम्बलिंग और पेइंग देयर डेट्स So, I think this is aesthetically quite beautiful. It's very balanced. You know, it's center placed, the carcass. The figure is placed, if you draw a grid using three lines on each side, you know, the figure is placed, the head of the figure is placed where those two points will intersect. You know, the law of the two-thirds, right? So he depicted brutality in a very beautiful aesthetic sense.
To me, it's violent. I mean, it's ghastly and violent. Dispassionately ghastly and violent. That's what I see in this. And then and weird actually, कोई mysterious लगता है कि वो छतरी लेके क्यों बैठा है इसके नीचे पता नहीं as if only thing I feel is this man who is being shown has caused all the violence and cut up the animal the ghastly destruction or not destruction I mean it's a horrible thing he has created and he's at the center of the stage and is guarding himself from getting bathed by the same blood which he has spilled it's something like that
the painting does not allow for a reading of content
no because it does no here I acutely tell you who is not allowing Who doesn't
just allow? The painting does not allow. I'll tell you why.
Why? I'm free to interpret anything
because,
I wish.
Yes, yes, yes. Because we just saw Ravi Verma before this.
Yes.
Now, the mythological paintings or paintings depicting historical events have a context one can relate to. You know, this does not have that context. The space is not here. The space
it's is not required. No? If it is, if the context is not being given, then I mean, who holds a gun on the head of the viewer that look, you are not supposed to interpret.
I'm not saying you're not supposed to interpret. All I'm saying is the painting does not allow it.
I don't know what you mean by the painting does not allow it. I'm thinking already.
I'm saying that the thought is not embedded in the painting.
I think strong thought is, heavy thought is embedded in the painting.
No, the thought.
Otherwise, how can one create such ghastly image?
The thought with respect to the content is not embedded in the painting. Is not embedded
I don't agree with you. I mean, definitely, once again, let us go back to another one. Definitely, there was. Let's look at this.
Would sir also like to add something?
You're asking me?
Yes, yes, sir.
You both are right on your part. Basically, what you say is painting doesn't allow means you should not go beyond what is being seen. But a curious mind is always there to interpret. So both are right in that case. You see, if a work is there, an artist has lived a life on that canvas, and if I want to interpret, I would interpret according to me, what I see, what I have, my perception. But originally, to read the artist's mind is very difficult, very, very difficult. You're not unable to decipher why that umbrella is there. That the artist can tell you know what happened exactly. So what you are saying is right. Don't try to read the painting. And on the other hand, what he is saying, it is natural that anybody who sees, he would try to find out the queries he's getting into his mind, like why that umbrella is there. So both ways, it is okay. For me, I'm not interfering.
And see, I'm coming here again. I opened another one. Again, another umbrella. Yeah, once again, an umbrella. Very strange. Achha, do cheez same hai. Dekho, agar pure aesthetics hi hai, kya hai, mujhe pata nahi. But something is there common. Let us open another one. I mean, I have not seen so closely Francis Bacon paintings. But
you see, I have opened my computer for this, and there is an X-ray image of the earlier painting what you are talking of.
There is an X-ray
image of this same painting.
Achha.
And it is showing some kind of arc instead of that umbrella. Have you seen that X-ray image of this painting?
How did you open it? I'll open it then. अपने क्या
इट इज पेंटिंग 1946 में इफ यू गो पेंटिंग्स 1946 एंड दिस इज दैट फ्रांसिस बेकन एंड ही हैज मोर पेंटिंग्स ऑन दिस आफ्टर ही हैज पेंटेड सेकंड वर्जन आल्सो इफ इट इज हिज ओनली एंड देयर इज वन
थर्ड इमेज
हां ओके थर्ड इमेज
Exactly.
Oh,
that one. Third image, yes.
This is an extreme image of that. It has another story to tell you.
No, so so I was talking about this, you know, the
as you said, it is accidental.
Yeah.
Dekho, niche aise lag raha hai. That he probably somebody tried to paint ribs down there.
Skeletons. Animals, yeah. Skeleton or something like that.
Exactly. Skeleton. Which might have been discarded.
And ultimately, finally he over painted it. So like he has hidden it. Final painting, maybe.
But
the railing is there also. railing is maybe that white paint is more dominating one, so it is coming in act today, but that railing is also there in act.
Yes, railing is very common in his paintings, you know. It keeps coming back time and again. There is one more. Let's see anything else. But if we see his paintings, no, there are few things I see very frequently appearing and all the time. Let us open this. That is kind of a damage, dispassionately damage shown on the painting, a destruction. After the destruction, not before.
Drastic destruction, in fact. Very cruel destruction, kind of.
Exactly. Very cruel destruction.
No, also, I think the umbrella just adds to the shock. Umbrella just adds to the horror.
Exactly.
Yeah, to see that painting without the umbrella, it would not be so
interesting.
Yeah, interesting and impactful as see it with the umbrella.
Yeah.
And he has used umbrella several times in other paintings.
Yes. There is all disfiguration, damages, all the paintings have.
Yes.
Now this is the interesting part. He was a self-taught artist. He didn't go to college. मुझे ऐसा लगता है that okay, some critics kind of say that he's he lacked skill. Some critics comment like that, and his paintings are sheerly dominated by utter passion. And he used to paint very fast, probably. Now what I'm saying is, at the same time, his friend was, his buddy was Luciano Freud. Now Luciano Freud is the grandson of Sigmund Freud.
He was master in his skill, I think. Luciano.
Yes.
Lucian.
I'm sorry.
He was master. His paintings shows mastery in his skill.
Extremely skill. Unka koi brush stroke dikhta nahi tha. Oh, mere ko samjha nahi. Wo kya bolta hai? He used to utilize the surface tension or something. Jo not a single brush stroke would be visible, and glistening kind of image hoga.
It's a term from physics, science, tension. That tension of that the out every liquid has a what you call tension in its outer surface, and that holds the thing. That physics is there.
हाँ तो मतलब पता नहीं
यू वांट
क्या
यू वांट टू पिक एनी इमेज
यस यस वी कैन नहीं मैं ना आई वांट टू पिक अप द पोर्ट्रेट व्हिच ही डिड ऑफ फ्रांसिस बेकन
दिस वन द फर्स्ट वन इज आल्सो गुड
नहीं दैट इज नॉट दैट पोर्ट्रेट
राइट प्रोफाइल
या दिस वन. This was stolen, actually, never found back. Yeah, cool, right? Yeah, this one. Achha, malum hai, this was painted on copper. I know, people paint on copper. I don't know. This is the portrait of Francis Bacon that was done by Freud. Now, this is a weird thing. If you notice, सबसे अजीब सा लगता है this stretch of this eyebrow. ये देखो ये खींच के center तक आ गया. ऐसा तो होता नहीं है. This is definitely not likeness.
हाँ Lucian Freud maintains that you know, his paintings are exactly the way we are. So if you there must be a fold or something on Bacon's face.
Well, Lucian Freud said, I will tell you what he said exactly. Lucian Freud said, only thing he hates about portrait is if it looks in like, if it is, if it holds likeness with the subject. So essentially,
I have heard to the contrary, because he did a portrait of his daughter. It was a nude painting, nude figure painting. And you know, his daughter, when interviewed, she said, "I told my father that my hand does not look like that." But he said it looks exactly like that. And later on, she maintains that that is her hand. So you know, I mean, I'll
exactly read out what he said. My idea of portraiture came from dissatisfaction with portraits that resembled people. I would wish my portraits to be of the people, not like them. Not having a look of the sitter being them. Not having a look of the sitter, but being them. And he used to want his subjects, jisko portrait karenge, usko jitna taklif diya jaye. Here comes a resemblance with Picasso, actually, in the psyche, I would say. He desired to make the subject extremely uncomfortable or disturbed or whatever. The impression which he would be receiving out of this person, that impression he would be painting. Now, here, if you look, and why I said there is a similarity with Picasso, because Picasso used to often inflict trouble in his people around them, around him, the people around him. Unko gussa dilate the, janbujhke, deliberately humiliate kar dete the, kuch kar dete the, that they would be at the edge of their emotion. And then he would be painting. He would paint, getting drawing inspiration out of the disturbance around him. Now here also, here if you see, आप देखोगे तो Francis Bacon की जो चेहरा है, ये ऐसा नहीं लगता कि the flecks on the side of his nose, as if he has been pinched by something. Suddenly it's a reaction, and it's, as it says, it's like a grenade about to burst. It's the age of emotion holding up the passion or disturbance or something. It's extremity of emotion, trapped, bottled up emotion, which will just go off like a grenade. Uske pehle wala chehra hai ye.
Okay.
This was deliberate, this distortion of the next to the eyebrows. It's a deliberate one. It's not that he had a photo. Dekho na, uska photo kafi hai Francis Bacon ka. Aisa kuch nahi hai. Now, I say they have a similarity, as if mujhe aisa lagta hai ki Bacon and Freud, isme Freud, Bacon was a sequel of Freud's emotional journey. It's like this, as if the grenade is about to burst here, and after bursting, what happens? The dispassionate destruction. Uski depiction hai Francis Bacon. Barbaad ho gaya phir. Okay. If we look at,
no, I think you know, I think they both paint in a brutal way. If you can show some other paintings also, yeah.
ये देखो, जैसे पहले वाला फेस में ब्लास्ट हो गया, बॉम्ब ब्लास्ट, फिर ये फेस निकला. ये है Bacon.
नहीं, some of Freud's paintings.
हाँ हाँ, ये Bacon है. ये मुंह का वारा बजा. आई थिंक दिस इज
नीचे है दिस वन सो यू नो दे आर बोथ ब्रूटल इन द सेंस दैट यू नो देयर इज इन फ्रॉइड आल्सो देयर इज इन फ्रॉइड देयर इज एक्सेसिव एम्फोसिस ऑन द फोल्ड्स ऑफ द स्किन something we consider to be ugly and something we consider to be a sign of aging but in Freud there isn't that excessive emphasis on the highlights and the shadows and the folds of the skin so the person looks like a very aged person at the same time the person looks like a very alien person you know very away. Not of this world very solid very you know hard as I see it
yes okay maybe this person looks hard but not all of them just
all of them, all of them his later paintings he no, this is his signature style this is his signature style
ये शायद
नो दीज
उसका वाइफ ही कह रहा
है दीज आर ओल्डर देन द या दीज आर ऑफ हिज यूथ आई थिंक
हां दीज आर
ऑफ हिज यूथ आई थिंक बिफोर ही डेवलप्ड दैट स्टाइल इन हिज ओल्ड एज ही डेवलप्ड दैट स्टाइल
यस आई मीन दिस इज व्हेन ही मैरिड दिस मैरिड किटी दिस फर्स्ट वाइफ तो इसमें कहा हार्डनेस तो नहीं है
नहीं दिस इज नॉट हिज स्टाइल हिज स्टाइल वॉज नॉट डेवलप्ड येट अभी आप रॉथको के पेंटिंग्स देखोगे तो रॉथको के फिगरेटिव पेंटिंग्स है शुरुआत में बट दैट इज नॉट अ सिग्नेचर
हियर आई डिसएग्री विद यू व्हेन ही अबे पिकासो बोलोगे तो फिर फिगरेटिव है पिकासो का लास्ट आफ्टर क्यूबिज्म व्हाट ही पेंटेड अ फुल bodily forms to usko picasso bologe
I am talking about his distinct style
acha look agar aap aise bologe I don't mind we shall disagree Lucian Freud ka last wala which I love the one which sold at some 30 million dollar or something हार्डनेस का दिखता है आपको
द सेम एम्फोसिस ऑन द फोल्ड्स द शैडोज
बस दैट इज द टेक्निकल पार्ट बट द एम्फेसिस ऑन शैडो एंड ऑल दैट ऑल फाइन बट व्हाट इज द इंप्रेशन व्हाट वी फील अबाउट द पेंटिंग व्हाट इज इट ट्राइंग टू कन्वे
इट लुक्स वेरी सॉलिड इट लुक्स वेरी सॉलिड
आई डोंट नो इफ दैट इज द thing I find something else iska naam hai actually that is also most important and I strongly feel that painting sometimes
this is his signature style this is the style I'm talking about
to isme solid lag raha hai ya floppy lag raha hai aisa lag raha hai ki ye matlab bahut aaram se soya hua hai I mean the feeling what we get out of it how he painted it he darkened the shadow or not is another story but
See that yes, is sir. See the natural quality of the model is that of you know sagging skin etc. But I think it has come to a degree. It has come degrees towards solidity when he paints this.
Yeah, that's a technical part.
Part is important. No, Lucian Freud is technical part.
No. Say, let us take this. This is a classic representative of his. This is a representative of his painting, Rohan. This one, which is done at a very end, actually, perhaps the last portrait he did. And the name matters quite a lot in case of paintings because if it is only skill. If it is you are talking about only skill how
I'm not no. let us
yeah your voice is gone or mine
technical aspects.
वापिस आया हाँ
हाँ I'm saying the technical aspects are part of the content. Okay.
हाँ part of the content उसमें denying
हाँ so one cannot just say that you know it's technical and hence it does not matter. It matters.
हाँ but how he did comes next ना
it's no it's
his, बाद में की बात है.
It's his visual vocabulary.
You know, yes, but what is that voice coming to us, reaching out of this? I don't think a piece of art is for that who understands how the dark patch is painted, how the brush stroke goes. People don't care about it. People just look at a piece of art and feel something. That's all.
That is people. Now, I mean, we are trying to understand Freud. And
try to look at a feel at all, then it has no difference between a cupboard and a painting.
I am not describing how he painted.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you what is his signature style? What makes him different from other artists? Now, if you do not find that aspect important, I don't know what makes Freud an important artist for you then.
Yes, the reason Freud is important is this, not because how he painted the fold, but because many people will paint the fold that way. That's not a skill, is not anything unique or anything unique for anybody at all in today's world. But the very idea of portraiture has been presented in a different way over here. Portrait,
what different way?
Yes, I tell you how it is different. Portrait, when we talk of portrait, like for instance, you make a portrait of Mahatma Gandhi. Or कल किसी ने मोदी का बनाया तो नाउ द पॉइंट इज हुज पोर्ट्रेट अच्छा मोदी पोर्ट्रेट वी नो दैट गाय मोदी पता है या महात्मा गांधी पता है ठीक है अच्छा हाँ वैसा हुआ नाउ हियर इट इज ऑल्सो ए पोर्ट्रेट इवन लुसियन फ्रॉयड्स पोर्ट्रेट ऑल्सो इज ए पोर्ट्रेट बट इफ यू डोंट नो हु द हेल मोदी इज इफ यू डोंट नो हु द हेल महात्मा गांधी इज वो एक आदमी का फेस है आपसे क्या मतलब है हमें क्या मतलब किसका मुंह दिखा रहा है कोई फर्क ही नहीं पड़ता या सो इफ यू लेट अस से लाइक फॉर इंस्टेंस रोहन ओके आई विल नॉट टेक द प्रेफरेंस हियर ओके यू शोड मी अ पोर्ट्रेट यू डिड यस्टरडे आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू द स्पेसिफिक्स यू शोड मी अ पोर्ट्रेट व्हिच यू डिड यस्टरडे द पॉइंट इज इट इज समबडीज पोर्ट्रेट राइट यू नो एंड आई नो बट इवन इफ इट इज नॉट समबडीज पोर्ट्रेट It is worth looking at and thinking for hours together. It doesn't leave your head. That is where it stands out. Because then it becomes an artwork. Otherwise, किसी का फोटो अगर कोई बना रहा है तो दूसरों का उसमें देख के मतलब क्या है? This is where this painting also stands out. Because we don't know who this is, right? We don't care who this fat woman is.
If we follow what you just said, then it does not make him any different from any other modern artist.
Yeah.
Because
that's why he is modern artist, no?
No.
A portrait done in a modern way.
Okay. Forget the modern part, but you know, then it does not make him any different than any portrait artist. Because those other portrait artists' portraits are also worth looking at. Without knowing the person.
No, I don't think I can open. अरे अबे 15th ये अपना रेनेसा टाइम का कि until French Revolution and counter Reformation and Reformation of Church जिस द पोर्ट्रेट के बाद पोर्ट्रेट पेंट करते गया आपको देख के क्या फर्क पड़ता है कौन सी काउंट है कौन कोई ऑल्डरमन है कोई पोप है कोई क्या है हमें क्या पता मुझे क्या फर्क पड़ता है वो आदमी को देख के
Exactly.
हाँ, but इसमें फर्क पड़ता है ना इसमें फर्क पड़ता है Are you not trapped immediately when you look at this weird picture? And
I am. But
you are right.
I'm trapped looking at a lot of paintings.
आप ऐसे generalize करोगे तो फिर portrait पे आ रहा हूँ.
So the technical aspect becomes important.
Oh, hold on, Rohan. At least bother to appreciate the meaning of this painting, yeah?
Actually,
the meaning is in the technique. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah, yeah.
Actually, मुझे लगता है रोहन कहीं पे कुछ और कहना मांग रहा है जो समझने की भी बात है कि ओरिजिनली होता क्या है कि एक आर्टिस्ट का एक अपना स्टाइल होता है जो स्टाइल सिग्नेचर की वो बात कर रहा है. इसमें अगर आप देखोगे रिंकल्स को वो कैच कर रहा है, ठीक है, वो पोर्ट्रेट बना रहा है, लेकिन उसकी अपनी जो स्टाइल है वो उस रिंकल्स को, उस फोल्ड्स को कैच करने की है. और वो अगर इस लेडी को आप देखोगे, इस लेडी को ही नहीं देखो आप, लेडी के पीछे जो सोफा है उसमें भी उसने रिंकल्स कैच करे हुए. और इनफैक्ट इसका जो ब्रेस्ट, जो ये टमी वाला पार्ट है जिसको ये क्या बोलते हैं, जो पेट के ऊपर जो छेद होता है, उसी साइड पे जाके देखोगे जो सोफे का जो पार्ट है, सोफे का जो लेफ्ट हैंड साइड का जो पार्ट है, उसमें सेम रिंकल, सेम स्पॉट दिखाने की कोशिश की गई है. तो अब यहाँ पे जो आप कह रहे हो कि इसमें आर्टिस्ट कुछ कहना मांग रहा है, तो हो सकता है वो कहना मांग रहा हो कि ये सिमिलर है, मतलब इसमें और इसमें कोई फर्क नहीं होता. लेकिन जो रोहन कह रहा है कि रोहन के इसके जितने भी पोर्ट्रेट्स इन्होंने किए हैं उसमें आप देखोगे इसका रिंकल्स पे बहुत स्ट्रेस है, मतलब बहुत ज्यादा रिंकल्स को उसने कैच करने की कोशिश की हुई है. पोर्ट्रेट तो वो कर रहा है लेकिन उसका जो ओरिजिनल जो उसका जो पैशन है ना, उन रिंकल्स को आर्टिस्टिकली कैच करना, उसको अपने हिसाब से दिखाना, वो एक उसका स्टाइल सिग्नेचर है शायद यहाँ पे बात है.
एग्जैक्टली यही मैं कहने की बात कर रहा हूँ और ये भी इम्पोर्टेंट है, इतना ही मेरा कहना है.
और आप जो कह रहे हो ना कि मोदी की आप बात कर रहे थे, मैं कहता हूँ चलो मोदी छोड़ो, आप मोनालिसा के केस में, हम मोनालिसा को नहीं जानते, कोई भी नहीं जानता, सुना है कि हाँ ये इतना इतना इतना, लेकिन उसके बारे में कोई इंटरेस्ट नहीं है. इंटरेस्ट किस में, कि वो जो पेंटिंग है उसमें क्या है. तो वो मोनालिसा तो सेकेंडरी है, मोनालिसा एक नाम से ज्यादा कुछ नहीं है, ओरिजिनल वो पेंटिंग है.
मोनालिसा फेमस इसीलिए हो गया, नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स ब्यूटी, उससे कहीं गुना अच्छा उसी टाइम पे सेंट जॉन पेंट किया था लियोनार्डो ने, वो काफी अच्छा है. ये हो गया इसलिए कि ये 1911 में चोरी हो गया था. This is what made it, अच्छा चोरी हो गया था, फिर उसके बाद लोवर में किसी ने कॉफी फेंक दिया था उसके ऊपर. हाँ, ये सब कई सारा रीजन के वजह से that became a cult figure, but it is, I mean, and then फिर
मेरा मतलब वो नहीं था, मेरा मतलब आप जो कह रहे थे वो ठीक कह रहे हो कि हमें मोदी के पोर्ट्रेट में भी एक आर्टिस्ट को अगर देखोगे तो मोदी को नहीं देख रहा होगा, वो पेंटर को देख रहा होगा कि इसने करा क्या है. और वो एक पेंटर का या आर्ट लवर का एक पैशन होता है कि वो पेंटिंग में ढूंढता है कि पेंटर क्या कर रहा है, उसे मोदी के पोर्ट्रेट से कोई लेना देना नहीं है. यू राइट ऑन दैट पार्ट, आप दोनों ही सही बातें कर रहे हो, दोनों बस उसको मुझे नहीं पता, लेकिन मुझे लगता है आप बिल्कुल ठीक कह रहे हो कि मुझे अगर मैं एक पेंटर के हिसाब से देखूंगा और अगर लियोनार्डो ने मोदी बनाया है तो मैं मोदी को नहीं ढूंढूंगा, मैं लियोनार्डो के काम को ढूंढ रहा हूँ क्योंकि मुझे पेंटिंग में पैशन है ना. और अगर कोई पॉलिटिकल लीडर ढूंढ रहा होगा या कोई भक्त ढूंढ रहा होगा तो उसको नमस्ते.
फोटोग्राफ देख लो.
हाँ
देख लो फिर.
हाँ नहीं फिर वो उसमें मोदी ही ढूंढेगा ना, जिसको आर्ट से कोई लेना देना नहीं है वो उसमें मोदी ही ढूंढेगा.
करेक्ट.
ये पर्सनल परसेप्शन वाली बातें हैं सर.
Now, ये पोर्ट्रेट मैं फिर भी बता रहा बोल रहा हूँ कि ये पोर्ट्रेट अलग है. दिस स्टैंड्स आउट क्यों, इट्स वेरी डिफरेंट बिकॉज पहले तो हमें पता नहीं, अनलेस वी डिग इन टू इट वी डोंट नो हु दिस इज, ये कौन है पता नहीं. ऐसा अजीब सा है कि ऐसे पड़ा हुआ है, आधा सोया हुआ है, ड्रोलिंग मतलब नींद में है या आधा नींद में है भी वो मालूम नहीं है. नाउ इसकी एक नाम है, इसी माने यूजुअली द मॉडर्न टाइम्स में जितने सारे आर्टवर्क हुए है यूजुअली उसका एक नाम रहता था एंड द नेम ऑल्सो द टेक्स्ट गिव्स अ हिंट टुवर्ड्स द मीनिंग व्हाट ही इंटेंड्स टू डू, व्हाट ही इंटेंड्स टू कन्वे. अभी इसकी नाम है बेनिफिट्स सर्वाइवर स्लीपिंग. नाउ ये नाम बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट नाम है एंड ही वाज अ ब्रिटिश आर्टिस्ट एनीवे, सो इन्होंने ओरिजिनल नाम ही है बेनिफिट सर्वाइवर स्लीपिंग. नाउ सर्वाइवर किसका होता है, आई मीन सब वॉर सर्वाइवर होते हैं कि जो भी है, एक्सीडेंट सर्वाइवर हो सकता है, मतलब कुछ गलत हो गया उसका, उसमें बच के जो निकला
वो सर्वाइवर है, ठीक है,
वो सर्वाइवर है। लेकिन इसकी नाम है बेनिफिट्स सर्वाइवर स्लीपिंग। नाउ अगर आप बोलेंगे कि ये नाम भी ऐसे ही दे दिया है, कोई टेक्स्ट जोड़ दिया करके, वो तो नहीं हो सकता।
अगर अगर आर्टिस्ट ने दिया है तो वो
सोच के दिया होगा, कारण से दिया,
कारण।
अच्छा, तो
बेनिफिट्स, बेनिफिट्स यानी जो वेलफेयर होता है यूएस यूके में, कि आपको बेरोजगारी भत्ता मिलता है।
एक बॉस, यू नो दिस और यू आर इंटरप्रेटिंग दिस?
नहीं नहीं नहीं, उसको बेनिफिट्स बोलते हैं, उसको बेनिफिट्स बोलते हैं,
बराबर है, बट
कैजुअल कैजुअल यूजेज में।
बराबर, यू आर थिंकिंग दिस वे, बट आर यू talking, when interpreting the benefit survivor sleeping this way, or you know the background?
I'm interpreting it this way.
Interpreting, okay. Let me tell you, no, it was not, because benefit, like the way you said, I didn't think. अब बोला सही बोला, एक मतलब वो भी निकलता है, लेकिन मैंने ऐसे नहीं सोचा। मैंने सोचा benefit survivor में तो बहुत benefit मिला किसी को, ज्यादा life में benefit मिला तो आप benefit ले लेके इतना मोटा हो जाओगे। हाँ, आप मोटा हो जाओगे और यू विल हैव ब्लडी इंडाइजेशन इन लाइफ, ओवर बेनिफिटेड, यूर चाइल्ड ऑफ बेनिफिट।
रोहन, आप लोगों ने देखी है दूसरी पेंटिंग, एक और बनी हुई है इसकी, सिटिंग पोस्चर में बट स्लीपिंग।
हाँ हाँ हाँ, है ना। अरे उसके नीचे देखो, लेडी बैठी है, शी वॉज अ गुड फ्रेंड ऑफ हिम, दैट्स व्हाट आई एम कमिंग।
सो इज दिस योर इंटरप्रिटेशन और डू यू नो दिस?
No, I know, and then I interpret this, then I understood the meaning, because why he did it, because ये जो lady है, जिन जो उनकी दोस्त थे और जिनको उन्होंने paint किया, some Sutile or something, I forget the name, must be written here. See,
एक मिनट, बीच में इंटरफेयर कर रहा हूँ, उसमें benefit supervisor resting लिख रहा है, it's not survivor, it's supervisor.
सॉरी सुपरवाइजर, ओके ओके,
तो माय इंटरप्रिटेशन आई मेड
बेनिफिट सुपरवाइजर रेस्टिंग,
सो माय इंटरप्रिटेशन इज करेक्ट देन?
ना ना, आई थिंक सो,
शी इज अ बेनिफिट सुपरवाइजर आर पीपल हु एडमिनिस्टर द बेनिफिट,
बट हां, बट सी हैज नथिंग टू हैड नथिंग टू डू विद इट, absolutely nothing to do that benefit, Rohan, and jis time pe paint kiya gaya, mere khayal se uske sath koi sambandh nahi hai. This is a lady who had indulged in throughout his life a happy life with lots of food, lots of drinking, lots of what I should say, all kind of pleasures. She plunged into all kind of pleasures in life and she doesn't care.
No, but see, does
celebrated the, does life, simple as that.
Benefit supervisor changes the meaning completely from see, what you're supervised, saying.
See, organized yeah. parties, see, organized wild parties all the time. If you read it, the background is written. Wild okay. parties and all that. I'm not spelling out the details. I mean, which borders on the... what do you mean? Is it right or wrong? This will come all the time. तो
मेरे को मतलब, मैं ये कह रहा था कि बेनिफिट सुपरवाइजर से ऐसा तो नहीं लग रहा है कि वो एक करप्ट लेडी के बारे में बात कर रहा है, कि जो ये सुपरवाइज करते हैं उनकी कितनी सोर्स ऑफ इनकम हो जाती है और कितना फ्री का खाना मिलता है और उससे बॉडी होती है, ऐसा कुछ तो नहीं हो रहा है?
एग्जैक्टली, मैं वही बोलना चाहता हूँ, इट इज बिट लाइक दिस, इट्स ऑन द बॉर्डर लाइन, एग्जैक्टली, सो दिस इज what do you mean out of
it? I don't know. I still see him as an objective painter rather than coming painter with who gives statements. I see him as an objective painter, objectively appreciating beauty that he sees in his subjects, rather than a political comment or a comment of sort.
Social comment, you
think? Yeah, I don't think it's a social comment.
रोहन, सोशल कॉमेंट, सोशल कॉमेंट मैं नहीं बोल रहा हूँ, मीनिंग सी देवर फ्रेंड्स, राइट, देवर फ्रेंड्स, दिस लेडी, आई फॉरगेट द नेम, ली और समथिंग, टेली और समथिंग, देवर क्लोज फ्रेंड्स, एंड नाउ ही हैज सीन दिस वुमन एज अ फ्रेंड फॉर मेनी मेनी इयर्स, एंड दिस इज हिज इंप्रेशन अबाउट द वुमन, and he paints the impression which he feels about the woman, not the outwardly expression of the woman. Maybe the folds or whatever you call, that is his way of expression, his style, but he definitely never tried to project likeness. He tried to project what he felt about the person.
Is
I can see a lot of likeness in the photo and the painting. Personally.
Her name is Miss.
He himself Tilly. Said, but no. Sue Tilly, Tilly or something.
Her no, name I is think.
Miss Tilly,
yeah,
Miss Tilly
yeah.
who was nicknamed Pat Sue by Fruit.
Yeah.
Her name
Sue
is Tilly. Miss Tilly.
Tilly, yeah.
Tilly. Sue Tilly, and he used to call her Pat Sue.
Pat Sue.
S-U-E. Pat Sue. You're right. She is
now. Please read what is written. Please also read what is written.
It says
one of the Lucian Freud's
Miss Tilly, who was nicknamed Pat's Sue by Freud, began posing for him in the early 90s, earning $20 a day, and was painted by the artist 4 times.
No, sir. What is on the screen? What I can see on the screen.
Fertility goddess you are talking about?
No. One of Lucian Freud's more famous paintings depicts... fertility goddess taking a nap on a sofa. She is naked. She is naked and seems to be in an unguarded sleep. Her face is partly squished and she looks like she might be drooling. Despite this, she is majestic. She has curves on her curves. And they professor, what is it?
In their phosphorus chamakra.
How did the artist sneak up on her? Okay.
Friends, etc. I read the story. No, but this sold at $30 million. Na kitna? $33.6 million. But this stands out. This is different.
Painting. सिर्फ पेंटिंग नहीं बिकती, उसके साथ की हिस्ट्री बिकती है, उसके साथ की
स्टोरी. Exactly.
That's बराबर.
That's what I'm saying.
मतलब उसके साथ जो कहानियां जुड़ गई हैं, उसके साथ जो एक हिस्ट्री है, उसके उसका जो बैकग्राउंड है, वो सारा बिकता है, इसलिए इतनी महंगी पेंटिंग बिकती है. नहीं तो ऐसी पेंटिंग्स की कॉपी बिक जाए आराम से.
वी आर एट 1 o'clock. इन दोनों को छोड़ देते हैं अभी. हो गया लुसियन फ्रॉयड और ये लुसियन फ्रॉयड सर. अभी कौन बचा? अरे
सुधीर पटवर्धन.
सुधीर पटवर्धन. रोहन विल किल मी इफ वी डोंट डिस्कस अबाउट सुधीर पटवर्धन. आई लव्ड इट बट अंटिल यू पीपल टोल्ड मी आई डिड नॉट नो. रोहन यू आर द बेस्ट. कौन सा खोल बोलिए.
I doubt that. Any painting, open any painting. All his paintings are good.
Like it.
Yeah, this is a very nice painting. So Sudhir Patwardhan ji, was very left leaning in his youth. Later on, he got disillusioned by it, and his paintings also show that. But there is a very strong connect with the common people, or strong connect with the lower classes, so to say, in his paintings.
Lower middle class,
or even lower than that, because he shows slums. He shows So a lot of his paintings are juxtapositions of developing a city. At the same time, underdeveloped city, like this painting, which we can see right now. So there is development going on, and at the same time, there is an undeveloped section.
In contrast, like yahan pe building dikh raha hai, ban raha hai, aur the down is like this. Yeah.
Yes.
Sorry, beech mein bol raha hu. Mujhe lag raha hai, it's like capturing calmness behind the chaotic world.
yes
dono opposite yes. Gadab, he very beautifully presented a calm situation, but if you go in details, you'll find chaotic world of the life.
मैंने ये इसके मैंने काम सराउंडिंग के पीछे आउटसाइड के पीछे
वो पेंटिंग रहने दो ना ये
अच्छा
बात करना है मेरे को
उस ठीक है ठीक है व्हिच वन वी ओपन दिस वन
हां तो ये पेंटिंग में तुम्हें दिखेगा बैकग्राउंड में लोग ढूंढ रहे हैं कुछ तो गिरा हुआ और ये लेडी के हाथ में कुछ तो उठाया हुआ है उसने वो चेक कर रही है अंदर क्या है Oh, you know, this shows the stupidity of common people sometimes. So he's not just he's also critical of the common people. And his paintings evolved from doing one person portraits to doing multiple persons with the same level of detail. If you can show some
लोकल ट्रेन बहुत सही था वो आई लव
सो हियर हिज पेंटिंग्स हैव इवॉल्व टू शोइंग द यू नो समथिंग दैट रिप्रेजेंट सोसाइटी एट लार्ज वन काइंड ऑफ सोसाइटी एट लार्ज रादर देन डूइंग इंडिविजुअल पोर्ट्रेट्स which he used to do initially. And there is also a strong influence of his earlier left leaning in, you know, you can see in this painting. It's his most common subject is the city of Mumbai. Mumbai in particular. And I think when you paint a city, when you paint different sections of a city, it represents universally the condition of inequality and the tendency, the universal tendencies of people stuck in the situations not of their choosing.
Yeah, it's more like a portrait of a city rather than portrait of an individual.
Yes.
I loved it. Another thing I felt actually, which I was telling the other day, that but there is किसी का ना painting के साथ में similarity लगता है मुझे. I remember Edward Hopper.
नहीं. Edward Hopper
style में.
Edward Hopper is all single. Most of them are single figures.
One second.
And It's about the alienation caused by modernism rather than
yeah. फिर अभी मैं जब स्टाइल बोल रहा हूँ तब आप स्पिरिट बोल रहे हैं.
The styles
are different. स्टाइल बोल रहा हूँ.
The styles are also different.
There is a translucent element in both of their paintings.
Look at the color.
This is Edward Hopper. One second, I'm opening. There is a kind of translucent कहाँ गया है यार अभी एक खुला तो दूसरे में आ गया no this मैं बता रहा हूँ क्यों मैं बोल रहा अच्छा ये देखो ये तो खोलने I was trying to open this अच्छा
नहीं ये दोनों में similarity तो है क्योंकि दोनों ही की हाँ कंपोजिशनल जो स्टाइल है वो मिलता है. हालांकि दोनों के सिनेरियो अलग हैं, दोनों के कलर्स अलग हैं, फॉर्म्स अलग हैं, बट जो कंपोजिशनल एक बेसिक एलिमेंट है जैसे खिड़की से बाहर देखना, पूरे वर्ल्ड को खिड़की से दिखाना, रूम इंडोर सिचुएशन से एकदम बाहर की तरफ झांकना, ये तो सिमिलरिटी की तरफ है हल्का. मतलब ये नहीं कह रहा हूँ कि ये कॉपी हो रहा है, ये
ना डेफिनेटली ना, सवाल ही नहीं होता. कॉपी नहीं बट
रिजेम्बलेंस तो है.
मैं जैसे इस चीज का बोल रहा हूँ एक वे ऑफ पेंट, वो पेंट मतलब एक ट्रांसलूसेंट सा चीज है, एक आई डोंट नो जैसे एज इफ वाटर कलर देख रहा हूँ ऐसा लग रहा है, व्हेयर एज इट इज नॉट वाटर कलर.
थोड़ा सिमिलैरिटी मे बी.
हाँ, इसने सब्जेक्ट में भी कहीं पे सिमिलरिटी हल्की सी आती है, हल्की सी. नॉट द सिचुएशन, नॉट द क्लास, नॉट द नॉट दैट बैकग्राउंड, बट दैट हल्का सा कहीं पे है. एडवर्ड ऊपर ने भी सिटीस्केप्स किए हैं बहुत सारे.
अच्छा रोहन, सॉरी आई इंटरप्टेड यू, कैरी ऑन.
आप बोलिए, यू गाइस कैन कंटिन्यू द कन्वर्सेशन नाउ.
नहीं नहीं, प्लीज प्लीज बोलिए, हम तो
टूरिस्ट. बोलिए
बोलिए रोहन.
ये देखिए, मैं ना रोहन, मैं इसका देखो, ये मैं बोल रहा हूँ, ये वाला देखो. हाँ. देखो ये थोड़ा ऐसा नहीं लगता द स्टाइल, मैं बोल रहा हूँ, वेरी सिमिलर.
लेकिन मैं बॉडी बॉडी ऑफ वर्क के हिसाब से बोल रहा था कि यू नो कंपोजिशनल सिमिलरिटी है, मैं भी मानता हूँ.
हाँ, वही मैं कह रहा हूँ, कंपोजिशनल सिमिलरिटी है, कंपोजिशनल सिमिलरिटी है, बाकी कुछ नहीं मिलता.
अच्छा,
दोनों डिफरेंट उससे काम कर रहे हैं.
इट्स ऑयल और एक्रिलिक और वाटर.
सुधीर पटवर्धन वर्क्स इन बोथ ऑयल्स एंड एक्रिलिक्स.
अच्छा, नॉट वाटर कलर है.
नॉट वाटर कलर, नॉट वाटर.
नहीं देखो, मैं बता रहा हूँ, ये जो फ्लोर पे रिफ्लेक्शन जो मतलब स्टूल की दिखता है, इट्स सो सो ग्लोइंग एंड स्मूथ एंड काइंड ऑफ इट फील्स एज इफ इट इज वाटर कलर लाइक दैट. दैट्स व्हाट आई सेड. मतलब मैं वहीं पे सिमिलरिटी लगा मेरे को हॉपर के साथ. एनीवे, या एंड इट द कलर डजंट इम्पोज ऑन यू, इट डजंट अटैक योर आईज. It's kind of very.
So, what is special about Sudhir Patwardhan is, even though he's painting today, stylistically he remains modern.
Right.
Why is that? Because his paintings connect to a universal. You know, because his subject is city, his paintings connect to a universal rather than becoming subjective like the recent. Postmodern and contemporary paintings are, you know. Oh. So he still remains modern, even though he paints today, and that is what I aspire to be, you know. Also, someday when I can make sense of what I'm painting. So he's a practicing radiologist. He was not a full-time painter.
Yeah.
Okay.
Most part of his life.
Yeah,
in 2005 he retired, and he's been just painting ever since.
Self-taught again.
2005 he retired.
Yes, 2005 he retired.
Okay.
He's a brilliant man. I had the chance to meet him in Bombay. And I still have his autograph, which I have preserved very. Nicely.
Okay. I mean, I'm just really mesmerized by his paintings. Anyway, strange kind of stuff. Okay. I think we are through with all four.
Okay.
Joel ji, bore nahi hua na bahut zyada?
नहीं, मैं तो बहुत एक्साइटेडली एंजॉय कर रहा हूँ. आप बिल्कुल मतलब मेरे लिए ये फर्स्ट था जूम पे जाना, लेकिन उससे अलग क्या है कि इस लॉकडाउन के टाइम पे हम आर्ट की बातें कर रहे हैं, इससे ज्यादा क्या फ्रेशनिंग होगा.
ठीक है, ओके. सो आई थिंक
ओके, थैंक यू.
आई वुड लाइक टू से समथिंग.
प्लीज प्लीज. Finally.
First of all, I would like, I would like to say huge thanks, Shankar Rakhi, to invite me. I'm really grateful to listen to you all. And I don't know much about the paintings in details. So it's my pleasure listening to you to all. It's a good experience for me. I learned to learn. Thank you so much all.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Bye,
thank
everybody.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye.
बाय।